you're watching Street Smart on Bloomberg TV India. Now, remember, the last couple of days, we've been trying to get some perspective from the FIs to get a sense as to what the outlook is for the Indian markets. What do they actually want to see from the new government itself? And joining us to discuss the same this morning is Chandrasekhar Samshivan, Investment Director at Invesco. He's joining us live from Hong Kong. So, Chandrasekhar, thanks so much for taking the time out to talk to us today. Let's start off by getting your thoughts in terms of what you make of the new government that's coming at the center here, and also the key expectations that the FIs and the market hold now.
Well, at the outset, let me tell you, this is a watershed event as regards the electoral verdict.
Okay.
And I think India is at an inflection point. And in terms of next 4 to 5 years, or maybe much longer than that, I think we expect that India is likely to scale new heights in terms of economic growth. Now, what brings that sort of confidence as regards investors like us is very clearly, let's step back and understand what was the problem during the last 4 or 5 years. The economic growth had collapsed, and the reason for that is perhaps the spending, both coming from public investment as well as private expenditure, had meaningfully reduced. We have seen clear issues related to governance. We have seen clear issues related to debilitating the governance, how the government was continuing with the policy paralysis, and also very high price rise. Now, if you take this as a backdrop and where we are currently sitting in, I think in all the three segments which I just mentioned, this government provides a lot of confidence. At least whatever we have heard in the press, as well as whatever the track record in the various state government led by BJP, as well as Mr. Modi, how he has done it during the last 12, 13 years in the state of Gujarat, provides that sort of confidence.
Right. Chandrasekhar, of course, there's a lot of a lot of confidence that's come in from the fact that it's a majority, the fact that, you know, yes, he's pro-development and so forth, and the sentiment seems to be very positive. But he does have his task cut out for him. The challenges do loom large. You've been talking about growth, and just getting that going, kickstarting that in itself is going to be a bit of a challenge. How long do you think really it's going to take to really see some of these things happening on the ground?
Well, without a doubt, it will take some time. But I think the most important thing which will give some confidence to investors by and large, both domestic as well as overseas, is the right sound bites to start off with. Some amount of measures to initially which can be called as a low-hanging fruits, and then it would be a medium to long-term in terms of the reform process. What I mean to say in terms of immediate sound bites is at least talk about all the things which will give some amount of confidence to the investors in terms of kickstarting the economy. Let's look at the three major issues which perhaps can be addressed in the time to come, both in terms of what measures the government is likely to take, at the same time what sort of right sound bites they can perhaps engage with. As I mentioned earlier, I think the economic growth which has slowed down to about 4 to 5%, I think the most important point for India is to get back into high economic growth rate as quickly as possible. Now, by meaning that, what I mean to say is that what are the key things the government can initially kickstart with is engage with the industry, ask them to start getting investment back into the country, which they have perhaps held on for last couple of years. In terms of public investment expenditure, I think one of the key issues which we have witnessed is the entitlement program, which was not able to reach in terms of asset creation and to the last mile advantage in terms of consumers. All it did was increase some amount of consumption, and it also led to price hike as a result. So I think we need to just look at government's views in terms how would they like to reverse this thing, rejig in terms of increasing spending more towards social infrastructure, and also allow it to engage with the private sector to start investing. Now, that will immediately give some amount of confidence of getting the investment cycle back on track. Second is on the price rise, which we have seen in terms of how inflationary the environment was. I think there are a couple of things which the BJP's manifesto has spoken about. They're talking about the Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee Act, which is commonly known as APMC Act. Some amount of reforms there is would help a lot. They're talking about national agriculture scenario, which perhaps will, with the help of a little bit of technology, will help us a lot in terms of getting the price rise under control, and also not allow so much of wastage of the food grains which we have witnessed in the last so many years. These are the immediate, I think, low-hanging fruits government can take into consideration, and which will give some amount of confidence of investors, both domestic as well as foreigners, to start looking India again as an investment destination.
You know, that's really the big question. As you mentioned, there's a huge to-do list out here. There are a lot of things that he needs to probably get into in terms of the investment cycle, in terms of reforms as well. But the question out here is, markets itself are trading around life high levels itself. We've seen a huge rally coming in on a pre-election basis as well. How much of this optimism already do you think is in the price? And what kind of outlook do you see, let's say, from a 6 to 12-month horizon for the Indian markets?
No, I take your point as regards market has given the spurt in the rally in terms of stock market performance. And that's exactly what I meant by it is some amount of hope has built up. But let's not look at from that point of view how much the market has already discounted. If you look at next 4 to 5 years, I think if we are able to clock in terms of corporate earnings in excess of 15% to 20% on a CAGR basis, I think that would be really helpful in terms of investment sentiments to be improving. Now, if you look at last 10 years, I think a decade has a couple of cycles involved. Maybe FY4 to FY10, I think the corporate clock close to about 18% to 19% growth in terms of profitability. The last 4 years were close to about 3% to 4%. So if you go back to, you know, high teens to maybe middle teens at least in terms of corporate profitability growth, I think that would be good in terms of how the stock market will likely to start discounting going forward. The second thing is, I think there are structural issues which perhaps will be taken care in terms of medium to long term. And I mentioned a couple of them. There are a host of, you know, the structural issues needs to be addressed to. I think if this government, which has perhaps the best electoral mandate in the last 3 decades, if it's able to, you know, implement some of them, I think it will give a lot of confidence going forward for a long time to come.
So then just one more thought in terms of the Indian markets out here is, what kind of themes would you be focusing on? Because as Invesco itself, you're one of the large investors in the Indian markets itself. What are some of those themes that are on your radar right now when we talk about the markets at the current level?
Well, themes are nothing new need to be discovered, but I think focus area perhaps will increase in certain things. To start off with, I think the last 4 or 5 years, certain sectors which haven't done well, and more specifically on the interest rate cyclicals, that is one thing which is likely to do well. With all the issues which I mentioned, perhaps government will start addressing them on a case-by-case basis. The second thing which I think the BJP's manifesto also has spoken about 3 or 4 themes which I believe they would be addressing it in the time to come. One is they have given a lot of importance to tourism as a infrastructure sector. I think that gives a lot of hope in terms of getting foreign exchange into the country, as well as I think India has a lot to offer in terms of tourism to the global travelers. The third would be defense. I think that is one thing, again, the manifesto has spoken about, and I believe government would likely to do a stress upon and also do a lot of reforms in this particular sector. Perhaps fourth, I would put it down to agriculture. I think Mr. Modi has also gone on record of talking about the contribution to GDP. He would like to see over a medium to long term as 1/3 each to the 3 segments of the GDP. So I believe agriculture growth, and I also touched upon related to inflation. I think that would be the key in terms of the government's focus area. And maybe finally, if one has to see how railways and other infrastructure-related sector are likely to attract investments. So these are the typical themes I believe I think the government will start to focus in once they take office.